Edward Teller, known as the father of the hydrogen bomb, once heralded thorium as the nuclear fuel of the future, a statement that piqued curiosity. However, despite thorium's immense potential as a cleaner and seemingly boundless source of nuclear energy, it was overshadowed by uranium-based nuclear power plants prevalent in our world today. This leads us to question whether we made an error by disregarding thorium or if its obstacles were simply insurmountable. Thorium boasts numerous advantages as a nuclear fuel, capturing attention with its abundance compared to uranium, which is found in various countries worldwide. One compelling aspect is that thorium produces less nuclear waste than uranium, as thorium reactors can be designed to employ a closed fuel cycle, wherein nuclear waste is reprocessed and recycled back into the reactor. Such an approach not only reduces the volume of nuclear waste generated but also lessens the burden of storage and disposal. Yet, thorium presents challenges of its own. Chief among them is the need for a distinct reactor design compared to uranium. Thorium reactors remain in the experimental phase, raising concerns about their safety and reliability. Moreover, the necessary infrastructure for thorium is yet to be established, demanding significant investments for development. Thorium reactors diverge from their uranium counterparts by employing thorium as a fuel. While thorium offers several advantages over uranium as a nuclear fuel, thorium reactors encounter their own technical hurdles. A prominent challenge lies in the requirement for a different type of fuel. Uranium reactors use solid fuel rods, while thorium reactors rely on a liquid fuel mixture typically composed of molten salt. This circulating liquid fuel mixture undergoes nuclear reactions within the reactor core, heating it to generate electricity. The utilization of a liquid fuel mixture in thorium reactors presents several advantages over solid fuel rods. For one, the liquid fuel mixture offers superior control and regulation, enhancing reactor safety and efficiency. Additionally, it facilitates easier reprocessing and recycling, reducing the amount of nuclear waste generated by the reactor. However, the liquid fuel mixture also poses technical challenges, such as its highly corrosive nature that can gradually damage reactor components. This difficulty in containment heightens the risk of accidents and leaks. Another technical hurdle associated with thorium reactors is the necessity for a distinct neutron type to initiate the nuclear reaction. Uranium reactors employ fast neutrons, whereas thorium reactors require slow neutrons. This necessitates reactor designs that can decelerate the neutrons before they can be absorbed by the thorium fuel. The disparity between reactions in uranium and thorium reactors lies in the type of nuclear reaction employed for energy generation. Uranium reactors utilize nuclear fission, a process involving the splitting of an atom's nucleus into two smaller nuclei by bombarding it with neutrons. This fission process releases substantial heat energy, which is then harnessed to generate steam and drive turbines for electricity production. Typically, uranium reactors employ enriched uranium fuel, wherein the concentration of uranium-235, the isotope most easily split in a nuclear reaction, has been increased through processing. Conversely, thorium reactors employ nuclear transmutation, a process that transforms one element into another by altering the number of protons in the nucleus. Within a thorium reactor, thorium-232 is bombarded with neutrons, eventually leading to the production of uranium-233. This uranium-233 can subsequently serve as fuel for energy generation, similar to uranium's role in a nuclear fission reaction. Though thorium nuclear power plants are once again in the development phase, their history extends back to the 1950s when researchers initially delved into thorium's potential as a nuclear fuel. During that era, the United States heavily invested in nuclear power development, viewing thorium as a promising alternative to uranium. Alvin Weinberg, the director of the Oak Ridge National Laboratory in Tennessee, played a significant role as an early pioneer in thorium nuclear power. In the 1960s, Weinberg and his team successfully developed a prototype thorium reactor known as the Molten Salt Reactor Experiment, MSRE. This small-scale reactor effectively operated for several years, utilizing a liquid fuel mixture of thorium and fluoride salts. Despite the MSRE's success, the U.S. government ultimately decided to focus on uranium reactors rather than thorium reactors. This choice was partly influenced by uranium reactors' established track record and proven reliability, whereas thorium reactors remained in the experimental stage. Consequently, thorium nuclear power remained a niche area of research for decades, with only a handful of countries investing in its development. India stands out among the nations that have explored thorium's potential as a nuclear fuel, given its substantial thorium reserves and continuous exploration since the 1950s. In recent years, the interest in thorium nuclear power has experienced a resurgence, driven in part by concerns surrounding climate change and the imperative for cleaner energy sources. Several companies and research institutions are actively working on the development of thorium reactors, aiming to establish them as a viable alternative to uranium reactors. Leading the charge is ThorCon, a company that envisions a thorium molten salt reactor claiming to be cheaper, safer, and more efficient than traditional nuclear power plants. Flibe Energy, another company, is also engaged in thorium reactor development and has received funding from the U.S. Department of Energy. Although thorium nuclear power has yet to achieve widespread adoption, it remains a promising field of research and development. With its potential to generate cleaner and more efficient nuclear power, thorium could play a vital role in meeting the world's escalating energy demands in the future. Thorium, however, is not the sole contender. Nuclear fusion, which involves merging atomic nuclei to unleash energy, has long been hailed as the ultimate solution to our energy needs. Nonetheless, despite decades of research and development, nuclear fusion has yet to be realized on a commercial scale. One of the primary challenges with nuclear fusion is the requirement for extraordinarily high temperatures and pressures to initiate the reaction. This necessitates a significant input of energy, while the technology to sustain the reaction is still under development. Moreover, concerns persist regarding the safety and environmental risks associated with nuclear fusion. In conclusion, while thorium exhibits promise as a cleaner and potentially limitless source of nuclear energy, it is not without its challenges. Establishing the necessary infrastructure for thorium requires considerable investment and remains a work in progress. Nuclear fusion, while promising, has yet to materialize on a commercial scale due to its technical difficulties. Ultimately, the future of nuclear energy will depend on various factors, including safety, efficiency, and environmental impact.